bladesmiths. In just 3 hours, each of you has formed a signature serrated edge blade using nothing more than steel tools on your workbench. Good job. Now it's time for the judges to take a closer look at your work. Jared, you're up first.
One of the things I like is subtle recurve. What I don't like is how skinny it is. But because you left some weight back here, it feels pretty good in the hand.
We're going to be doing a tatami slice. Serrations will catch from tatamis, but your serrations here are very tight that actually should slice all the way through. Good job, sir.
Eric, please present your blade to the judges.
I pulled it to the Zombie Slayer Club. Did you put that hole there on purpose?
Yes.
By putting a hole at the end of that split won't travel either direction. That's smart work.
Thank you.
Your blade that we're using to slice doesn't have any serrations at all. So the serrations on top, you aren't in danger of breaking on that.
This strategy. Harlan, you're up.
Harlan, one of the coolest things on this is your serrations back here.
I had never tried that before, and I don't know where it came from.
Man, that's pretty aggressive. Well done.
Thank you.
Into the finger well? Not a good place to lose metal. Because what you're doing is you're creating a weak spot in that blade.
No, I know.
The main concern I have is the numerous cracks we see.
As soon as it went in the oil, I was questioning myself why it went in when it didn't.
Okay.
Ryan, you're up.
I like your subtle lead curve. Your forge well looks good. There are a couple cracks. We're noticing on the spine back here.
Okay. I didn't know so good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Feel the blade's very light, so definitely going to be faster to use velocity to cut through. And I like the tight serrations on this. Good strategy.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, gentlemen, now it's time for the judges to discuss the finer details of your work. Please leave your blades. Thank you.
I don't notice anything you guys are doing. The whole world just kind of collapsed around me.
Cease in that moment.
Let's go ahead and take a closer look. We'll start with Jared's blade on the end.
I'm not crazy about the fact that he's the edge of the grinder to make his serrations just because it puts points as opposed to scallops. There's a little bit of a whoop-de-doo in there.
Jason, maybe the technical definition of whoop-de-doo?
The technical definition of whoop-de-doo is a curve followed by another curve, but in the wrong direction. But this way, we call it a knee curve, not sexy, but this way is moving.
I'm just hoping that my blade fully hardened.
Mine definitely got hard, but I felt so
good. Let's talk
a little bit about Harlan's blade. It is by far the most dramatic and beautiful serrations on all the blades. Nicely done.
Yeah, whenever we see our smiths not go through the process of thermocycling, we see a lot of this kind of cracking.
Let's take a look at Eric's blade.
Looks like it should be aboard a Klingon battle cruiser. Somewhat reminiscent of like a Wakizashi or something, so I think it will help cut well if it gets a sharp.
Putting serrations not on the edge that we're going to be testing is interesting, because now he doesn't have to think about the edge catching on to the top units. The one thing I also want to bring up is he water quenched this, and we don't see any cracks.
Let's move on to Ryan's blade.
He's got a nice subtle recurve. His serrations are small enough that they dig into the tatami mat, but also the points will break off in the ice.
There are some cracks on the back of this blade where the files were welded together. One file or the other is cracking, so that kind of tells me that maybe the metal's not one piece.
Ryan's blade has cracks, Harlan's blade has cracks, Ryan's cracks on the spine, Harlan's on the edge. Of these two blades, which one is worse than the other? Doug, have you determined which of these blades is doing?
Yes.
Dave?
Yeah.
Jason?
Yes.
Alright, let's go talk to Jason. Jason has finished the deliberation. It's time for one to
Have you done that banana? Now you want to see what mom's doing? What are you doing, man? What are you doing? The weather. I'm taking the rocks off the floor because I burnt the candle and I was like, noisy now. Maybe I won't do that. Annoying my tortoise. Meet the weather. Meet the weather. Appetizer. Yeah.